Loss. Well, my dear children, the present poem, the ball poem, here in this poem, a boy is upset. How and why? The boy is upset due to loss. Dear children, loss is natural. Since the word go, since the day we started our life, loss is a part and parcel of life. It is natural. Loss is natural. How it is natural? As everything has some certain life. Both living and non-living things have some certain aspect of life. You may be wondering that why I am telling that non-living have also lives. Suppose you purchase a refrigerator. 7 years of warranty is given to that compressor. Why? It is warranty is the replacement. It means for the 7 years that compressor will work promptly. The refrigerator or the air condition cooling machine is designed to work effectively at least for the 7 years. So my span of a life, I want to tell you that even the non-living things have some span of life. Here, the very idea of loss. The poet wants to teach us that loss is natural. He wants to inculcate the very idea of loss and wants to hit upon the very idea that loss is natural and we should try to cope up with loss. And if we could cope up, if we know how to deal with the loss, and we can get control or we can get rid of that loss, then it is very important. Simply a ball, just a simple thing, ball. It does not cost much. It is very easy. It is not difficult to buy a ball. But the very association with the ball is important. Even if you purchase a toy, when you purchase that toy, the cost that you pay may be cheap or dear. But so long as the toy is with you, so long as the ball is with you, the very association between you and the ball, between you and the toy, is very important. We become such a possessive that we think that ball is a part of my life. We cannot do anything. Such a strong sense of possession prevail on us. So here the very strong position that the that has prevailed, that has governed in poet's life. The boy has lost his ball. Look at the line. What is the boy now who has lost his ball? The poet asks a question. He is asking question to you, to the reader, or to anybody, whoever reading this poem. Now, look at the situation. The boy has lost his ball. So what kind of a situation, what kind of a mental picture, what kind of a psychological impact he was in? This is what the poet wants to hit upon. What is he to do? A boy is a helpless boy. It is not the boy. We all are helpless in the hands of God. When eternally God kills us for our sport. The great poet William Shakespeare has rightly said, we are just like a playthings in the hands of God. As flies to the wanton, why we are to the God. The wanton boy who kills the fly for his sports, for his fun, the same is with us. God kills us like a wanton boy just for a sports sake, just for fun's sake, just for a business sake. So here the boy is helpless. How? Because he could not hold the ball properly and it lost. He was startled. He was in a fix. He was sad. He was at his back foot and was thinking about the loss of the ball. I saw it go. The poet say the boy has seen the ball, how it has gone. How? When he was merrily, happily bouncing down the street, the boy was happily bouncing and playing with that ball in the street. And happily there. Happily it bounced back, bounced more than that, and it went into the water. So the boy has lost the ball when he was playing with it in the street. He was bouncing happily. By chance, it fell into the river that was falling by the side of the field, by the side of the street where he was playing, by the side of the bridge. No use to say, oh, there are other balls. No repair. The poet says that there is no use to say. It will be quite useless to say that if you will provide another ball to that boy, the boy will become happy. No. Not at all. The boy is not going to be happy to get another ball. He wants only that ball, the ball that he has lost. Why? It shows the very strong relationship between the boy and the ball. So the ball is non-limiting. But when it was, we become so much possessive with our belongings that we feel that it is a part of our life. Even the greatest batsman, the greatest footballer, the greatest boxer, they become so much possessive with their own belonging, like the bat. Sachin Tendulkar was so much possessive of his bat that he used to carry in his kit the old bats. He loved that old bat more than the new bat because the bat is very much accustomed. They associate good lucks with the non-living things like bat and ball. So here the boy is the same. The boy is in the same situation. He don't want to compensate. So here the poet is saying that there is no use to say that replace it. No. The boy is not going to replace. The other ball cannot be compensated by that ball that the poet has lost. Why? Because the very old association with that ball was that much strong to the poet that the poet doesn't want to compensate a new ball from the old ball. So this is what? An ultimate shaking grief. So a grief, a sadness, and a happiness, a sorrow has badly ceased. Capture, fixes, came upon, fixes the boy as he stand rigid. There was rigidity. Why the boy was rigid? He wants to get that ball, the ball that he has lost. And looking at the rigidity, the poet could not dare to ask him to replace the ball. For that reason, he says that, oh, there are other balls. There are so many balls, my dear. But the ball that the poet has lost was very, very special for him. Though it was non-living, but with the passage of time, it has developed a bondage. The bond between the ball and the poet was strong. We also associate with our pen, the pen. Oh my God, where is my pen? The pen that my father has gifted me on my birthday. Why it has become special? Because that pen reminds you about the very special day, the birthday that you celebrate. So here, the boy is standing rigid. Why? Because he wants that ball. Trembling. He is trembling, shaking. Trembling what? Trembling to look at the ball floating, going away from him. And was staring down. Looking down all his young day into the harbor. And all his young day, he was looking wherever he could. Goes there. He looked down to that harbor where once he has lost his home. He has become young. But whenever he saw that down, the very loss, where the very loss of the ball haunts him, his ball went. Went is a past incident. The poet is young. Now he is not a child. In the first extranjā, he is the boy, but now he is young and he is standing rigid at the harbor and looking down, down at the bridge. And he looks down, he becomes start shivering, trembling. He became rigid, as if he become lifeless. Look at the so much strong relationship with the ball that the poet was in. I would not intrude. The poet don't want to disturb you. The poet didn't want to disturb him. Why? Why? A dim another ball is a worthless. A ball can be purchased in a single dim. Dim is a currency. In a dim, on a few rupee, in a little money it can be purchased. Now he senses his busters. The poet wants him to learn the responsibility. If you don't learn the lesson to lose, when you lose something, then you learn the value. Losing is very important. That is why it is called failures are the pillars of success. When you lose something, the poet wants to learn him the first responsibility. Being a man, being a boy, being a young boy, it is our first and foremost responsibility to learn from our mistakes. Dear children, mistake is natural. Even out of, if I am trying 100%, at least there's always a chance of 10 to 15% of mistake. A wise person accepts his mistakes because he knows that mistakes are natural. But a foolish people makes fun of the other mistake. If somebody is walking, making fun and laughing at your mistake, it means he is a foolish man. A foolish man blames the mistakes. He talks about other mistakes. A foolish man makes other man's mistake a point of discussion, a point of argument. But a wise person praise the mistakes. He will say, yes, mistakes is possible. So don't worry about, my dear children, mistakes are possible. What is the main thing that we should learn? That we should try to learn from the mistakes. The more mistake you will commit, the more you will learn. Nobody is perfect. Even Almighty God is not perfect, what talk of us? So mistake, accept your mistake. Out of 100, there's always, always a chance of mistake. And Gita mein bhi ye baat kaha gaya hai, ki mistakes to ho sakte. The great people like Vishvapitama have committed mistakes. What mistakes he have committed, you might be. I don't want to discuss upon that. So, the first responsibility, it is our first responsibility to realize that lost is natural. Why? If we could not learn, nothing in this life is permanent. Happily we come, happily we will go. when we are born, the day we are born, on that very day, our day and date of departure is written. It cannot be changed. We all are living to die. Death is imminent. We cannot avoid it. So, in this way, if I am going to have a child, have a family, a day I am going to lose it. So it is very first lesson that we should learn that lose is natural. Death is nature. And we should try to learn from the loss. How to cope up. How to make ourselves strong during the loss. We cannot get rid of the loss. Loss is natural. Accept it. And you see, this is the best way to get rid of your stress. Believe in the God. Think, oh my God, it is in the hand of God. What else I can do? In the village, people are so wise that they accept the loss. The first lesson. This is the lesson of loss the poet wants to take, to understand, to make the poet understand about the lesson of loss. In a world of possession, people will take balls and balls will be lost. In the world of possession, we purchase many things. The ball is a symbol of all the possessions that we do have. We try to collect. This is living. Our child is also our possession. Our family is our possession. Our father is our possession. Our relatives is our possession. So whatever we have, somehow, someday, somewhere, we are going to lose it. So we have to be responsible. We need to learn. We need to believe in this, that loss is natural. We cannot avoid it. And no one buys a ball back. If something is lost, it is lost forever. Money is eternal. Paisa eternal. Materialism can purchase the worldly comforts, worldly luxury, but it cannot purchase the peace of mind. It cannot purchase the health. It cannot purchase happiness. Quite natural. So the boy is learning. He is learning. Who is he? The boy. The boy is learning. And behind his desperate eyes, the boy is desperate about the ball. The boy is desperate about the ball. But still, the epistemology of loss, the grammar of the loss, the poet wants to teach the boy about the grammar, about the principle of the loss. How to stand up when you lost, how to pop up, how to collect yourself and stand up again, knowing what every man must do. And you must know the day how to. So you should know how to stand, how to cope up, how to deal with the loss. So this is what the, my dear student, for today. If you have any problem, please ask. Hello. If you have any problem, please ask. Harshit, do you want to ask anything?
No, sir.
If anybody have any problem, he may ask. Yes, please ask. Yes, my dear children.
Sir, okay. What is?
Yes. Yes, sir, speak. What is...
poem.
Hello. Hello. Okay, beta. Bye. Bye. Next class. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Okay, beta, bye.